top5rapwebsite.com. You already know what's going on. Today we got Alchemist and Action Bronson, Lamb Over Rice, little seven song EP project, whatever you want to call it. Track number one, Dimitri. So I'm excited to see what Alchemist does over on the boards for Action Bronson. Y'all already know how Alchemist get down. If you don't know, go watch my channel. Tons of videos. I talk about the Alchemist. A little Western 80s feel, you know, cowboy. You know what I'm saying? Already the production got me at a loss for words. I can't even talk. I'm trying to think what beat it reminds me of with those keys. Do. It'll come to me later. Sounds dope so far. You'll be amazed like the first time you see snow. So lyrically, Action Bronson, I think most of us kind of know what he has to offer. Some people say he doesn't sound like Ghostface. He sounds like Ghostface, but that doesn't mean he can't be his own artist also. He's kind of just real descriptive, and that's how Ghostface was. Real descriptive. That's how Raekwon was. Real descriptive. Action Bronson is just real descriptive. So I don't think we're going to be getting hit with a lot of bars. There's not going to be really many bars for me to break down. Bronson is not that type of rapper. There would be bars to break down if I were a chef, because I would be able to catch all his veal and seared foie gras, you know, and expensive cutlery references that he makes as a chef. Because as we all know, Action Bronson is a chef. I accidentally skipped away, but I was gonna say that he doesn't sound aged. He doesn't sound like he's coming to an end. Even though Action Bronson has been at this for a while now, he still sounds pretty hungry. And I think we can attribute a lot of that to Alchemist production. I really like this beat. With a vengeance, black man looking like Janet with extensions. I'm back on the bench presses. Put the Audi in a red dress. Make 10 lefts. I lost 50 on the mess. I'm a mess. After practice in the I lost 50. I like that little flow he just did. Let's go back to the Janet Jackson line. Black Mac look like Janet with extensions. I like that. You know what I'm saying? Let's go back. From the field, free sex appeal. The lone gunman. Muffled a shoddy with an old onion. This is no fun, never low funds, man. Fucking crazy. You must be out your mind. Back with a vengeance. Black man looking like Janet with extensions. I'm back on the bench presses. Put the Audi in a red dress. Make 10 less. I lost 50 on the men's. It's a mess. I like Action Bronson on this. I'm not like the hugest Action Bronson fan, but on this song, that's what I gotta do to be the best shit. Man, these motherfuckers sleeping. I'm Bronson banging pots and pants. Gotta understand these fake bucks are not your mans. Me disappear where I'm right here. Creeping in the cold nights here. To get on my level, take 50 light years. My jewelry box is like the habitat for white bears. My jewelry box is like the habitat for white bears. So let's really get to the bars, okay? I said there wouldn't be much to break down. But he is descriptive, so we can break down some of his descriptions. But as far as like metaphors and double entendres, I don't think we're going to get that with Action Bronson. That's not what I know him for. He said jury box looked like the habitat for white bears. So polar bears, you know, they live in ice. Saying he's icy. Coming from the pyramid, now I'm at the steakhouse. So he's just saying like, yo, you know, I'm that guy. Could have been in Guns N' Roses Dolo. Could have been all, how many members? Three members? Four members? Like a pogo stick. Don't you motherfuckers know that I'm the logo kid? And the logo. Don't you motherfuckers know that I'm the logo? Like Jerry West and Jenny Ballgate. I don't wear ball main. Swing the ball and chain, executioner style. Dirty mountain tiger to the face. Better strap up about the seat. Dirty mountain tiger to the face. So what does that mean? He's gonna stick an animal on you? See, these are kind of the bars that Action Bronson has, filler bars. And a lot of his bars are just kind of like filler. He just kind of, it's kind of more about the flow and the vocal inflection with him. And you know, the references that you won't get anywhere else, like habitats for polar bears or something like that. You're only going to get that from Action Bronson. Then there are some filler bars that he adds, you know, to kind of string the flow along. He's just, again, non-cicada rhyming. He's talking about, you know, being in the Nissan Center and the Queen Center. Now he's talking about his grandparents. You know, it's kind of all over the place. And that's what you get with Bronson. It's part of the reason why I don't listen to him that much. He is in my rotation. But once you've heard one or two songs, you kind of get the gist for what he's doing. But what's really making this stand out right now is his production. His grandparents learned English watching Martin. So, you know, they was watching some good TV. Martin was a great show. Knock him out the box, Bronson. He got that from Slick Rick at the end of the Trojan story. Knock him out, Rick. Knock him. You gotta listen to the Trojan story, you know, to get the reference. Anyways, I think we got the gist of that track, Dimitri. Track number two, Sven. So the intro to this kind of reminds me of Mad Lib, which is a lot going on. Mad Lib does that. He just, you know, throw you with, you know, four or five samples, you know, all at once, like here. Figure it out. I already know I'm not, again, I say this every vid, laptop speakers. I'm listening on phone speakers right now. I'm not getting this beat like I should be getting it, which is a shame, but, you know, gotta do a reaction for y'all. If you want to invest in this channel, click an ad, open the ad, let the page load all the way so we can invest in a speaker. It's like a diagram, a dying in a hand plug. The double shotty like a bed song. Special money in my eyebrows. Lift up the 5 pound wrist. Leave you cut up, licking and butter. I'll view the mountains once the sun's up. Do anything to get the buzz up. Motherfuckers is on the first stunt. Replays, I'm a master. Kick up a load to help me pay faster. Throw some acid on your cheek, now your art. Scars over my heart, the blood in the sharp European shark. And again, you know, more filler bars. But it's okay. Health is wealth, but wealth by the fancy belts. kindergarten student. I'm only part human. The whip sit Indian style. Like kindergarten students. So what does that mean? His car, the whip is a car, sits Indian style. So the wheels inward. I'm just trying to think what he's saying. I'm just trying to catch it. And again, people say he don't rap like Ghostface. Ghostface does shit like this. Like kind of like real descriptive, but vague on what he's talking about. That's Ghostface back. It's Raekwon's back too. A lot of the Wu-Tang does that. So when people say that Bronson raps like Ghost, it's just not the vocal inflection, which it does sound like Ghostface. It's the rhyme style too. Go listen to One by Ghostface Killah. Very coherent. He's speaking. He's enunciating his words. But it's like, still, what are you talking about? You know, Ghostface has a bar where he goes, crash through, break the glass, Tony with the gully mask. That's the pass. Heavy ice rolly laying on the dash. Something, something, cauliflower hurting when I took the trash. Something, something, something at the Wally Bass. It's like, you can understand the words he's saying, but it's like, I cannot connect and put together what you're saying. That's what I'm getting right here from Action Bronson. The whips in India style, like kindergarten student. I'm only part human, trying to get paper like Mark Cuban. Spark the Cuban, double park the Buick. What you do to beef, stew it, half Jewish. What you do to beef, stew it. And he's a chef, so that bar hit a little harder than if someone else were to say it. Like good homework, selling drugs, rolling on a blue shirt, chrome hearse, a star burst, cause the work was intense. The little driver named Sven used to kill a Ben. Shit strange, I can feel the wind. All this pain I can feel within goes away when I'm in a vent, but comes back when I'm staring in the rims. Take 10, stand on the wall like a blue hole. Dominican hoe with a culo, hey, Pecundo, they can't stun. AM and DJ do yo. And I'm gonna be hopping about the 2-0. If you ain't get caught, you better be ready for sure. Cause these motherfuckers ain't playing. These motherfuckers be spraying. From first look, you think I'm German to me. Okay, you know, so that was track number two. I didn't like it as much as track number one. With Bronson, that first track, is going to, all the tracks are going to have a similar feel with Bronson on any project. That first couple tracks might hit you harder because you're hearing it for the first time and it's the first track. But by the time you get to five and six, track five and six, seven, eight, nine, ten, you know, this album's only seven songs, but if it were 10 plus, by the time you get towards the end, you kind of get tired of what Bronson is doing. There's really no content, kind of rapping the same vocal inflection, not really changing the delivery. But for a quick, boom, five, six, seven songs, yeah, this is perfect. Track number three, Tear Away Shorts. Hey, Paolo, fix him a little bit on the side. Put some spoons in
straight up. I fucking tested positive.
That piano sounded like manic. Boom, 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 boom. That sound manic. The self you said the 250 got me looking like Lorenzo Lamas. Long trench shiny in it, at least a minus. Six flips into the whip like a Russian gymnast. The tear away shorts, it's back to business. I mess with this beat too. I'm gonna have to say this. Breaking up, take the paper in the morning, cop a bacon truck. Yup, turn the wheel like a new leaf. I'll have your mother naked cooking stew beef. Turn a wheel like a new leaf. Have your mother cooking stew beef? You know, so he must be on his stew season. It is winter time, so he's rapping more about stew. You know, shout out to stew, shout out to soup, shout out to chili, you know what I'm saying? Collard greens, grits, all them hot foods that keep you warm on a cold day. Cream of wheat, you know. Chariot American. I want to hear this beat the last couple seconds. Okay. I like that one. Tearaway Shorts, kind of short, but you know, it's okay. Track number 4, Accoutrement. Is it a French word? Y'all will have to excuse me, but you know, gotta refill on tea. I'm gonna let it bump though. Fuck around, found your leg by the Gowanus Bridge. Overdue with send your penis to your mama crib. Okay, so he mentioned filet mignon earlier. I'm gonna rewind that a little bit. In the middle of the cockpit, Spanish disrespect up is a mastridge. Quinceañera freak. Sitting in the middle of the cockpit, flying a plane. Spanish chick is, what'd she say? Laying up an ostrich. So she got ostrich fur. So he's just describing luxurious. He could just be in his house, getting high. I'm the pilot, flight school pilot, Wiz did all that. So people use flights and planes as a metaphor for getting high now. After Wiz did flight school, way back when, wasn't that long ago. Spanish chick laid a bit some ostrich, you know, just real luxurious raps. You know, that's what he do. Him, Rock Marciano, those type of dudes. Lyrical, luxurious rap. Raekwon, probably the godfather of that style. Staring in the middle of the cockpit, Spanish bitches played up in some ostrich. Quinceañera freak dancing, Grand Hills laced up with the ex, Helly Hansen. Quinceañera freak dancing. Aren't they still kids? Like when they have their quinceañera? Isn't that like a 16? I don't know if a grown, I don't know, whatever. Friday night hustle to the sun up, stumble is synonymous. Fuck around, found your leg by the Gowanus Bridge. Overdue is send your penis to your mama crib. That's what happens when you open your vagina lips. Only focus on... Overdue is send your penis to your mama crib. That's what happens when you open your vagina lips. So he's talking to a dude, he's calling his mouth vagina lips, okay. Insult, okay. Mergers and acquisitions, comments on accounts, robbing them like yeah. But you don't want no problems, I got the opera lungs. I'm trayable jelly, hit the telly, lift my belly. Cover up the bonus stakers, baby, there's no mistaking. My life is Jesse Brandon, sophisticated ballad. Sweet, sour, salty, spicy, and umami. We eating oysters over diamonds in Hawaii. Umami, we eating oysters off of diamonds in Hawaii. Fool talk. Talk to him, man. Nobody else can talk to an audience like this about food. This is Action Bronson's niche. He got the food talk rap, and he got that in the bag. That play ball for the Liberty. Finish my second train and lighten up the trilogy. Like E. Honda when he's fucking up the Lexus. Google baby, it's all about the culture. Like E. Honda when he fucking up the Lexus. So y'all know that Street Fighter game where you gotta destroy the car. You know, I'm just glad I have all these memories in my childhood. I feel like being a 90s kid, I was early 90s though. So I remember a time before cell phones and before like the internet was widespread. But I also experienced cell phones and social media and all that new tech at a young age. So making a transition was natural. But I still remember when there was beepers. I'm 26. I still remember when there was beepers. I still remember when there was, you know what I'm saying, you know, not phones everywhere, you know, different technology, brick cell phones. People didn't even have cell phones. The bricks was out, but they was expensive. People didn't have them. So I'm able to remember certain things like the Street Fighter, E. Honda, certain TV shows, you know, local channels before we went digital and you had the analog channel. You could just plug the TV in, put the antenna on top and get channels 2, 4, 5, 7. You might get 4 if you got a good reception, 7, 11, 13. So I can remember certain things of the past, of the recent past, and I can also put you up on game on the new tech. So I feel like that early 90s, if you was born early 90s, that's like nice sweet spot. You know what I'm saying? You didn't grow up in a social media age, but you did grow up in a social media age. Back to Bronson. Oh, he just said how to say the word right there. Accoutrement, that's what I say. Monster, we fucking up the Lexus. Google wrongs, baby, it's all about accoutrements. Accoutrements. I don't think he's saying that. Accoutrement. If it's French, you don't say the NTS. Track number 5, Right? The five. Descendant of the Stars. So far, this is good. Let's keep going. Alchemist on the keys, man. He's not joking around with the keys on this album. What this band? Ooh, the way he came on that. The way Bronson just came on his beat. And that's deep. As a descendant of the stars, it's only right that I become one. So you know what they say about, you know, the human skin, what's on Earth, the amounts of, you know, stardust, gold, carbon, all of that can be found proportionally as it is on Earth within the human body. You know, that's what they say. So he's saying, I'm a descendant of the stars, you know, stardust. It's part of my makeup. So it's only right that I become one. So when you die, a part of that ideology is that, you know, when you die and you biodegrade and decompose, you contribute back to life form, you know, so you contribute, you know, back to the carbon, back to the stardust, the dirt, the oxygen, the air, everything. It's kind of like everything is perfectly 360 and complete. So, like I said, it's a deep concept. And he's just encapsulating that within like two bars, if I'm hearing it right. That's my takeaway from it. But dope. Very happy, upbeat due to the piano. Heavy, what's that in the drum? Wait for the enemy that came to wait. Snares are doing their job. I did an interview with GQ on taking a shit. What else he say? He talking shit. I like this. I'm gonna save this one too. I'm taking a shit. Oh, is he gonna talk about his furs? He said my jump shot got an arc like Noah. At any moment, 10 animals could roll up. So the perfect way to complete this bar, you gotta talk about how Noah had the animals on the ark. So obviously you're not about to roll up with animals, but you could say you got one of every chick and they all got on different furs. They got the alligator, they got the, I don't know what they make furs out of. I don't wear them. Let's see what he does. If not, that's a metaphor, man. Okay, he didn't describe his chicks and furs, which would be like completing the Noah's Ark animal reference like I wanted, but it's okay. I'm on the same drug that Hammer was on. Talking about MC Hammer. Yeah, It's me. It's only right that I become one. Okay, so I really like that one. That was one of my favorites on here so far. So I feel like I've listened to, you know, over half of this. It's good. One of the more memorable projects I've heard by Bronson as of late. Memorable. You know, with some Action Bronson projects, as I described earlier, you know, it's kind of some filler bars, and once you've heard one or two songs, you've kind of heard, like, what he's going to do. Like, once you've heard one or two Bronson songs, you already know his style. It's not really going to change much. But the way he's just meshing with this production, he sounds fresh. I said that in the first track. I said he sounds fresh. He sounds hungry. You know, so let's get to track number 6, just the way it is. It's me, it's me, it's me. And again, Alchemist with these pianos. He said, I ain't buying shit. She's the one tricking on me. Like, I got 5 pairs of Jordans. At least I'm famous and I ain't shit. Well, my mother loves me, I'm a baby. We still drive each other crazy. Man needs a liver, bought it off of eBay. Started snorting Pepsi, now we got a fiend's face. This is such an interesting beat. Like, I'm still trying to, a minute in, 45 seconds in, I'm still trying to figure out the beat. Had a pregame before the pregame. If you're in college, you know about that life. You can't come to the pregame sober. You gotta come a little lit. You can go give a free range. This is Jericho, no cherry curl. No more than 3 shots. Pregame. Take a couple, then you get to the pregame and finish the rest of your bottle. You don't wanna come to the pregame already shitty. He said, I put 100K on Army versus Ball State. Ball State's gonna win that, so I hope you didn't put it on the Army. Football, it's a football reference, college football. I just wanna be a normal person, but I'm special and I understand that you wanna see me rapping through the Running Man. But why you gotta be like that? That's just the way it is. Why you gotta be like that? That's just the way it is. Why you gotta be like that? That's just the way it is. And you wonder why my mind is filled with crazy shit. Okay, so on this song, we're kind of getting content, subject matter, which is a nice change. It's just not random food and women references. It's actually some continuity. Wow. Bitches one day, I'm disgusting, but I'm honest. Took some baby cleavage sinus. I had to take a shit inside the diner, so I pulled the rover over, let the shoulder like Israeli soldiers. Gassy butt naked in the green Buick. Huey Lewis and the news drinking 22s. And here it's like, okay, so what is he talking about? It's kind of one of those moments where it's like, okay, filler bars. No skin, bitch, I'm running through. They need the honey do, I'm running with the money crew. 5 glasses full of running shoes and I ain't running Duke. My girl jealous because she knows that I'm in love with you. My name LeBronson, not Guy Fieri. You get robbed for your chetty. My name Bronson, not Guy Fieri. He has a cooking show, Guy Fieri. Trust is to my console Yeti. Big shotty like a Yeti. Fuck the world tatted on the back. Yo, why you gotta be like that? That's just the way. Big shotty like a Yeti. The Yeti's big, or I mean supposedly. No one's ever seen him. Outro, track number 7, Arnold and Danny. Not sure who he's referencing with these two names. Yeah, I have the number one album in Okay, so a departure from the piano on this beat by Alchemist. Very familiar drum pattern. I'm gonna say it's the Funky Drummer by James Brown. Very familiar drum pattern. We hear this in a lot of hip-hop songs.
Oh.
trying to figure out where I've heard these drums. As long as she put her drug in her shit crack. That's a reference to Lil Wayne. What song was that? I see she wearing them jeans that show her butt crack. My girls can't wear that. Why? That's where my stash at. Where the cash at? How could I forget that? That's Currency song. Lil Wayne and Currency. Where the crack? Where the cash at? Crack in the butt crack. That's where that reference comes from. Whoa. Gotta rewind that. The bone in the steak is like a dinosaur leg. So he's talking about the quality of food he just got you. He's food bragging, chef bragging. Y'all don't know nothing about that. Remove from using phone books as abdominal plates. So I seen dudes do that, like when you think you about to get in a fight or you're gonna be in a tense situation, they used to strap like phone books around their abs in case you get stabbed, I guess. I thought he was gonna do the Griselda ad lib. Rock New Balance for alignment. You hate to see a motherfucker shining. I just bought my first pair of New Balances the other day. Let me show y'all. First pair of New Balances. And I used to clown these shoes relentlessly. But $30. A little rinky dink warehouse shoe store. These are like my little everyday shoes. What are these? 500s? I'm not really a New Balance, you know, huge fan, but you know, shout out to New Balance. I'm open for the sponsorship. I just gave y'all, no, I'm just playing. Sounds like the end. You still got another minute 40. No feet. So that's the Alchemist rapping. All right, the quick pick like a lazy drummer. Alchemist got bars. Stretched out in the sand with a Bambi. He been taking notes from Rock Marciano. Yo, I see you, Alchemist. I see where you got. You know, I see you. Okay, so that was Arnold and Danny. That was the outro, and that is the project. Lamb Over Rice by Alchemist and Action Bronson. And Alchemist is really, at this point in his career, he's really building his legacy. He's stamping and cementing his legacy with these projects that he's doing, whether it be this project, whether it be, you know, the work he did with Currency and Freddie Gibbs. Alchemist is really becoming a household name, at least for, you know, hip-hop listeners. He already was a household name with underground listeners, but now he's becoming, you know, more known. Action Bronson on this project, he sounded fresh, he sounded energized. I like this project. There was only one song where I kind of wasn't into it all the way, and that was Sven. It was only the second track, so I think that made it better. If Sven was like in the middle of the track list, I think I would have experienced some fatigue when I hit that song. But the fact that it's so early is kind of like, okay. Favorite songs, Dimitri, Tearaway Shorts, Descendant of the Stars, In a Coup Tremont. That was a good one too. Y'all know I don't like giving ratings on an album the first time I hear it. But if I had to give it a rating, I would give it 3.5 to 4 stars. It's a good project. I won't give it 4 stars yet. But it's very good. I gotta give it a couple more listens, obviously. But 3.5, 3.75, almost 4 stars. This is real good. I'm very impressed. Alchemist and Action Bronson. They deliver. This is how you deliver, folks. So, top5rapwebsite.com. Peace.